the Boilermaker Breakdown, your midweek recap of everything happening in Boiler Country. I'm Matthew Sound. Ahead, we'll take a look at what's happening in men's and women's basketball and see some highlights from wrestling over the weekend. But first, our top story, unprecedented success in track and field. Coach Lonnie Green's teams have been rolling early in the season. The women are currently ranked 14th in the country, which is the highest ranking in program history. The men are currently 32nd. The team swept a duel against Indiana earlier this month, and there have been great performances throughout the roster on both the men's and women's sides. But the Throwers have led the way with Danny Bunch and Chuck Inequici. Bunch has won three straight Big Ten Athlete of the Week honors and holds the top weight throw in the country and the second best shot put mark. Meanwhile, Chuck Inequici has the top mark in the world in the weight throw and is 11th in the nation in the shot put this season. I'm here with Purdue Track and Field senior shot put and weight thrower Danny Bunch. Danny, you're number one in the country in the weight throw, number two in the shot put. Is that something you thought you'd be at this far in the season?
Not this early, but I was expecting it to happen at some point in my season. But the fact that it happened so early and I'm holding on to it, I'm pumped about that. So.
You've gone against some good competition, but now this weekend going up against the best, the number two weight thrower, some of the top five shot putters. What changes about your preparation and what are your goals this weekend?
My goals this weekend are just to keep PRing, set some more records, and kind of treat this meet like a mini nationals. Since it is top athletes there at the meet, I'm going to, mindset-wise, go into it like it is nationals. So,
thanks for your time.
Thanks.
Now I'm here with Purdue weight throw and shot putter, sophomore Chuck Inequici. Chuck, you lead the world in the weight throw right now, top 10, top 11 in the shot put in the country. Is that something you thought you'd have success this early in your sophomore year?
No, I thought I'd have something like this happen maybe junior or senior year. So it's pretty cool that it's coming this early.
So you have had that success. Now you got a huge meet this weekend, the Finley Elites, going up against really just about the nation's best throwers, all of them. What do you do differently this week, or what's your goal?
Biggest goal is stay focused, stay technically sound. Don't get too nervous, because a lot of these guys I watched on YouTube while I was learning to throw. I message them, sometimes they message me, so there's a lot of respect, but I can't let that respect get in the way of competition. So just stay focused and try to get a big mark.
Well, best of luck to you this weekend and appreciate your time.
Thank you.
And now let's take a look at the rest of the breakdown. The women's basketball team is on a roll, having won four in a row. The winning streak began with a dismantling of Indiana on Katie Couric. The Boilermakers then hit the road for a two-point win over Nebraska in Lincoln last week before returning home to take down Northwestern. And on Monday night, Coach Versip's team defeated Illinois by double digits in Champaign. The 19th-ranked Boilers are now 15-5 on the season, 5-3 in Big Ten play. On the men's side, it appeared that Matt Painter's squad had turned a corner with a dramatic come-from-behind home win over Penn State a week and a half ago. But after two straight losses, one at Northwestern and then at home against Wisconsin, the team is hoping for a strong second half to the season in order to return to the NCAA tournament. After 2 months on the road, the wrestling team returned home Sunday to take on 10th-ranked Nebraska. The Boilermakers got a decision from Braden Atwood and a fall from Danny Sabatello, but it wasn't enough as the Cornhuskers defeated the Boilermaker squad 28-9. The women's swimming and diving team lost a close duel to Indiana down in Bloomington. The 18th-ranked Boilermakers got strong showings from Carly Mercer and Francesca Marr while sweeping the diving events, but it wasn't enough as the Boilermakers fell by fewer than 10 points. The women's tennis team had a busy weekend, falling to 32nd-ranked Tennessee on Saturday 4-3 before sweeping 56th-ranked Fresno State on Sunday. The Boilermakers are ranked 27th in the nation and have high hopes for the young season. The men's tennis team had their match at Cornell canceled due to harsh weather on the East Coast. Now that we're all caught up, let's take a look at the week ahead. Men's basketball hits the road with games at Michigan on Thursday and at Penn State on Sunday. The women return home for a Thursday night game against Penn State before heading to East Lansing on Sunday to take on the Spartans. Swimming and diving host the Big Ten triple duels at the Boilermaker Aquatic Center this weekend. The two-day event sees the men and women both take on Wisconsin and Minnesota. Wrestling heads to Bloomington Friday night to take on Indiana in a battle for state supremacy, then returns home Monday to take on Ohio State. Track and field heads to the Finley Elite Meet in Ohio on Friday in an event that features some of the nation's best throwers. Women's tennis welcomes TCU to the Schwartz Tennis Center Saturday, while the men head to Waco, Texas to take on 7th-ranked Baylor. For results throughout the week, go to PurdueSports.com.
And don't forget to check back in with us next week on the Boilermaker Breakdown.